own, a voyage of our own of discovering how safety and security mechanisms work within every institution. So it was this journey which was very important to us, and we discovered many things, and we finally found that the topic was extremely challenging, and it was extremely wonderful for us to have been involved with this topic, because we were able to see safety and security mechanisms in almost every aspect of an institution's life. For that, I think now I should thank Professor Pahade for giving us this topic. And also, because we did this journey together, I think I have made lifetime friends with Dr. Swati and with Dr. Amrapali. Having said that, I'd like to say that we began with the idea, which certainly concretized in our mind, was that safety and security is not only about infrastructure and about physical safety and security, about things that are there in an institution. Sir, can you all hear me?
Yes, please go ahead.
Because I can't see myself on my screen, so I was just wondering.
Definitely.
Okay, sir. Okay, fine, sir. So we realize that safety and security is not to do with just physical and infrastructural safety and security, but more important is the psychological safety and security of the stakeholders who engage with the institution, sociological and psychological safety and security of the stakeholders within the institution. This was the first thing we kind of made our stand on, that we look into this in a broader aspect of these two elements. Secondly, we thought, and this is also very important, we thought that when an institution gets into the mode of doing an NAC assessment, the assessment itself is the first step towards safety and security. I'll explain this by taking the metaphor of a doctor asking you to do a full body MRI scan. So when you do a full body MRI scan, the test reports tell you how you are. If your test reports are good and you get an A plus or an A plus plus, the institution is ready in that case to pick up more challenging things in the future and reach out further. The test reports might also tell you that certain body organs, certain things are not functioning to its optimum, in which case you take the necessary precautions, you take the necessary medicines, bitter pills sometimes, so that you are cured of the virus, or you protect yourself from the virus, which might come in and disrupt and create problems for your institution. So the doing an NAC assessment itself is the first process of being secure and safe. If you have a good assessment, you can feel very safe and very secure, and you can feel very confident that because my body polity is healthy, I can therefore go into newer horizons. I can explore newer things which I had not done before. The two things that we come from this is that safety and security are very closely related to the element of trust that is built up between the institution and the stakeholders in the institution. Trust is a very important aspect of security. Again, to take a metaphor, the child in the lap of the mother trusts the mother. She will not drop her. Therefore, the child can do whatever in the mother's lap. It is that trust that the student, the non-teaching staff, the teaching staff, the parents, the outside world has on the institution, that the institution will look after it because it has systems of in place which gives it security, which gives it a certain sense of safety. It's safe to study here. not only in physical terms, but also in your sociological and psychological terms. This trust building can only happen if the apparatuses, the mechanisms, the policies of safety and security are well placed right across every aspect of the institution's life. Followed from trust is the idea, I think, of reputation. When you have that kind of trust being built up because your mechanisms of safety and security are so strong, obviously your institution will have a reputation which will help you to move out, which will help you to get good students, which will help you to get your alumni back, which will help you to become more inclusive. It's only when you have that reputation. So this is a dynamic relationship between how you shape up your institution in terms of the policies that you have, which protects and therefore makes everybody safe within your institution, and the trust and reputation that the institution has. Finally, I'd like to end by saying that security and safety apparatuses, mechanisms, policies are not to do with the kind of institution you are in. It's not to do with big or small. It's not to do with if you are private or public, or if you're government funded or not funded. It's got nothing. It is a universal requirement. It is to do with every institution that is there. So it's an universal requirement that can the institution function with a certain with a kind of confidence and engage itself with the society around it in a meaningful and valuable way, giving back to the society what it gets from the society. If that I think is very important. So I have tried to give you a kind of a macro level understanding of what we all did. And now I'd request my colleague, Dr. Swati, to give you a micro level detailed look into various aspects of security and safety measures and principles which are operative, which should be operative in an institution. Dr. Swati.
Thank you, Samantha, sir. A very good evening to all the esteemed judges, Pade sir, Badrunisa ma'am, my colleagues, and all the participants. I request Samantha, sir, to put on our PPT because my video here is not working, I guess. Oh. I'll explain the PPT.
Oh, but I don't have the PPT on this laptop.
Amit sir, please share the PPT.
Yeah, even I have sent it to Amit.
So Amit sir can share
it. Amit sir will do it. Thank you.
Give me a minute.
Please share it.
Sir, can we talk about some point until and unless I upload, share my screen?
Yes, please. Yeah, can you see?
Yes.
Yeah, I've been able to upload. Taking cue from what Samantha sir has elaborately explained, our team believes that safety and security is a universal value, and it permeates deeply into several policies. And we are focusing on safety and security's tangible as well as intangible aspects. So we are considering it in terms of legal, physical, infrastructural, procedural dimensions, and also psychological well-being. Samantha sir also told that going itself for NAC, getting accredited, when the IQAC forms the quality policy of the institution, that itself enhances the safety and security of the institution. Why focus on safety? As it builds trust, it creates teamwork that adds to the repute, and it leads to the progress of the organization. Safety and security spans across all the seven criteria of NAC in different ways. We have listed down those which we found are absolutely relevant. The academic calendar, which a college prepares and puts it on its website, builds a sense of discipline in the conduct of programs, courses, activities. The student feels assured that the college really means to execute what it professes. The college is also expected to document all these activities, because this record is really very helpful for the audits. It is required even when we submit our AQAR, SSR, and also for the teachers during their career advancement scheme. Then, if we, in most of the colleges, we find that there are the large number of girl students. The parents will seek admission to their girl child only if they feel that it is safe. If the number of girls taking admission in your college is increasing, that itself speaks about the safety and security of the institution. Apart from that, various gender equity measures, gender sensitization programs have to be promoted through guest lectures, skits, and role plays. Self-defense workshops give practical demonstration on physical safety. There are also what is called as committees, such as Women Development Cell, Internal Complaints Inquiry Committee. These all familiarize the students with laws relating to women. Apart from that, the anti-ragging helpline has to be displayed on the website. The message should be loud and clear that ragging or sexual harassment of girl child will not be tolerated at all, and it will be strictly dealt with. In criteria 2, which focuses on teaching, learning, and evaluation, there too we found that safety counts. A sensitive and a compassionate environment is required to secure the psychological well-being of the students. The very fact that students from diverse backgrounds, those from outside the state, foreign students, seek admission in your college vouches for its safe environment indirectly. In fact, diversity and safety go hand in hand. The parameters of enrollment enhance the security of the institution. The institution, therefore, is expected to display tolerance towards cultural, linguistic, communal, and socioeconomic diversities. Transgender also needs to be displayed as a separate category on admission form. The college also classifies students into slow and advanced learners. The aim is to pay attention, required attention to the slow learners, as well as to boost the advanced learners. Many a times we find that the slow learners feel awkward to ask questions in the class. They feel really awkward to ask their queries, clarify their doubts. But once they know that they can approach the teachers in the college, even after the lecture hours, they feel really comfortable, and therefore they are able to also excel in studies. Mentoring is also a safety or a security measure psychologically. Next, we deal with processes. There are several processes which are undertaken in the college. Here we have highlighted exams. Exams are the yardstick to assess the performance of the students. They should feel that the entire process is fair and as per the due process of law. a student will not ask for revaluation unless he finds the process is safe. And therefore, these processes and procedures have to be established regarding verification of marks, revaluation, photocopy, medical cases. Sometimes students participate in extracurricular activities or sports during exams, so their re-exams can be conducted as per the university rules later. If students are caught in possession of copy material or resorting to unfair means, then too, they should be assured that they will be dealt as per the due process of law. Sometimes students ask for duplicate mark sheets. So the colleges have to tell them the entire legal procedure that has to be followed when they are applying for a duplicate mark sheet. Or when they go to their villages and somebody comes to collect their mark sheet in their absence. So we need to tell that the authority letter of the student is required. In this way, we can bring about that sense of security into the students about the processes that are followed by in the college. In criteria 3, which deals with research, innovation, and extension, we found that research takes place only when the environment is safe and secure. Otherwise, teachers hesitate to share ideas, resources. They may not take up innovative projects if they are not given its due credit. Therefore, teachers who come up with very innovative ideas need to be rewarded. Their efforts need to be recognized. Besides, there should be an anti-plagiarism policy which should be displayed on the website, which protects their research. Then there are MOUs which are signed by colleges with outside agencies. Now, MOUs with outside agencies should clearly define roles, responsibilities, and financial obligations. This can safeguard the institution from legal hassles. Same goes with patents. These have to be protected. Students undertaking extension work represent the college in fieldwork, and parents therefore need to be assured that their wards are safe. Criteria 4, as everybody knows, deals extensively with infrastructure and learning resources, and most of it is physical infrastructure. When it comes to gate and building, you have a watchman, the boundary walls which are secured, barbed fencing, parking facility for two-wheelers, a lift, staircases, maybe more than one for evacuation, the painting of the building, ramp for the Divyanjan, which makes them feel safe and which really helps them, signages in places. Then besides that, there are notice boards which are displayed. The water tanks are cleaned twice in a year, leakages are plugged, so the whole ambience also creates an impression. Coming to laboratories, which are very crucial, there the safety manuals have to be displayed. The journals of the students should have the first page which is related with safety. Fire extinguishers, fire alarms have to be installed. In the computers, there should be an antivirus software which has to be renewed and updated. The air conditioners, pest control, all is required in the laboratories. The students and the staff need to be trained to handle chemicals, to handle equipments. The deadstock register is required. A deadstock register is maintained for not only laboratory equipments, but also for all office equipments, even for the library. And it is very important because it helps us to weed out the outdated material or write it off by calculating its depreciation. It removes the unwanted and makes space for the wanted. The library has to be well ventilated and it should be computerized. There should be lockers where the students can keep their belongings. I have seen some libraries where there are facilities even for the Divyanjans. The tables are designed that way. Fire extinguishers have to be in place. It has to be computerized. To enable researchers, there should be softwares which can help them in research. Again, the plagiarism check software also will help the researchers. the barcode scanner is needed because it's helpful in stock verification also. Pest control has to be undertaken, and library timings, when they are extended during exams for the benefit of students, it really helps. Then we come to the exam room, which stores all the confidential data. It has to be exclusively used for paper setting, preparation of results, storing the answer sheets, mark sheets. It should be equipped with CCTV cameras, which can have backup facility. Some universities also have all guidelines related to digital delivery of question papers. There should be the copier machine, the shredder to destroy the unwanted papers. Even the exam software should be password protected. For online assessment of answer sheets, there should be a computer lab, and even that exam software has to be protected. One of the places in the college which the students never forget, even after they graduate, is the canteen. It's the coveted place for informal chats and meeting with friends. The canteen policy has to be spelled out clearly. The MOU with the vendor should have details regarding services, cleanliness, hygiene, waste segregation and disposal, and even that the food will be served at subsidized rates. Stale food should not be served. Pest control again is regularly required in the canteen. Personal hygiene of the staff very much counts, because they themselves should not be carriers of diseases. The food should be as far as possible not touched while being served. And the staff should make use of gloves and aprons. Water purifiers, aqua guards should be available, and the canteen area, including its kitchen, also should be very clean. You all must have come across at least once a scenario when the sound system during a program does not work or suddenly fails, and the guest is really put at severe discomfort, and all those sitting on the dais are just clueless. They look at each other, and those at the backstage, their palpitation just soars. In the auditorium, we have to ensure that the lights, sound system are functioning well. The cabling has to be checked. No broken chairs, because we have to rent this auditorium. Otherwise, the outside agencies will never hire it, and that will create a bad impression. For extracurricular activities, for cultural programs, for sports, we need to take police permissions for rallies. And even for sports competitions, we have to inform the police when we are holding it as an intercollegiate competition. For field visits, study tours, NSS camps, the undertaking from the parents is absolutely necessary. A lady teacher should accompany girl students during field visits and study tours. The facilities which can enhance safety are health center, which is equipped with first aid box, wheelchair, stretcher, a doctor on call. Then it also should have a register which is maintained regularly. The ladies' common room should have an attached washroom. Guidelines for using the sanitary napkin vending machines and the incinerator should be displayed, and girls should be actually trained to use it. There has to be a separate boys' common room. The staff room also should have comfortable chairs, tables, lockers, attached washroom. And some colleges also provide pantry, because the staff members work till late. A separate changing room for the pews is also desirable. No stinking washrooms. They have to be designed well. Then a personal counselor is also required, because the personal counselor addresses the psychological issues faced by the students. More number of students visiting the counselor speaks volumes that they are feeling secure to confide in their psychological problems. Information officer is a mandatory compliance under the RTI Act, and the RTI queries have to be answered in time-bound manner. Record room is a repository of all old records. It should be arranged neatly to access all records and should be labeled accordingly. The personal files of the staff have to be maintained by the office, and all documents relating to each and every staff member has to be stored into their personal files. The GR, student's GR, is one of the basic documents in the college, and it has to be updated every year after the first year admissions. Even bound volumes of results are also another safety measure, because you can access the result of any ex-student if he comes for any mark sheet, duplicate mark sheet anytime. There is also a facility which can be given, which is digital locker, where the mark sheets of the students can be stored in electronic format. Next are the annual maintenance contracts. They ensure the operational part of different equipments in the college. If the service provided by the vendor is not satisfactory, then the contract may be renewed. The AMC takes care of repair and maintenance cost of equipments like the lift, the biometric machine, water purifiers, water cooler, IT infrastructure, softwares, ACs, CCTVs, copier machine, Xerox machine, pest control, and fire extinguishers. Criteria 5 deals with student support and progression. Here, representation of staff and students in different committees increases their bonding with the college. They feel their voice is being heard. So this representation is quite required. Placements. All colleges are focusing on placements. We have to equip our students with a skill set so that they become employable in the market. Students, those pursuing traditional courses, often ask, oh, what are we going to do after BA? What are the prospects that we have? So during their graduation years only, we have to equip them with skill sets so that they do not face the problem of employment. Alumni engagement is also very much necessary, because it strengthens the bond with the institution and helps the current batches too. Regular survey and feedback from the students regarding safety and security needs to be taken, so that we know what are the loopholes or what the areas of improvement. Criteria 6 deals with governance, leadership, and management. A clear-cut policy regarding the physical and psychological security and well-being of the students and staff of the institution has to be in place. Adequate funds should be available for security measures. Decentralization should be practiced. Staff welfare and student welfare measures have to be undertaken. In staff welfare measure, I can cite that some colleges also give what is called as emergency loans for their non-teaching staff. So that can be a very good staff welfare measure. Office procedures and manuals, especially the filings, the way all documents are filed in the office, the way the records are maintained. It should not happen that we keep on searching from one file to another just to locate a particular document. So all, even the worn out files need to be replaced. There are statutory committees which are aiming at safety and security. So the Students' Council, Women Development Cell, Anti-Ragging Committee, Internal Complaints Inquiry Committee are an example of this. Apart from that, there is Grievance Redressal Committee for staff as well as students, Unfair Means Inquiry Committee, the Backward Classes Cell, and Group Insurance for students. Nowadays, staff is also trained into disaster management. They are taught about how to evacuate the building in case of fire. So mock fire drill is conducted. Students are told that they should not be using the lift, how to evacuate quickly from the staircases without causing any stampede. The non-teaching staff is also trained how to handle fire extinguishers. Then training to handle photocopy machine, copier machine, printers, laboratory equipment, gymkhana and sports equipment is also given. The sweepers are provided with gloves, safety belts, sanitary materials and equipments. The peons are also given uniform and ladders, because they have to sometimes look out for files which are on the loft. Financial security is very much important. And that can be ensured by keeping cash transactions to the minimum. That prevents chances of misuse, if any. Internal audit points out the loopholes, whereas external audit by the government, by the director's office, or by the AG office is absolutely important for aided institutions. And therefore, all records have to be maintained, be it the enrollment of the students of all previous years, cash books, bank books, musters, voucher files, all these have to be kept in order. Colleges which have availed grants from UGC, ICSSR, RUSA need to settle their accounts and obtain NOC from these funding agencies. This is one aspect which we have focused also in this PPT. We feel that employees spend half of their life at work and their workplace becomes their second home. Those who fail to maintain their personal files and records are always sure that a college has a copy of it. An institution has to care for its employees from the day he joins till he retires. So the letter of appointment, probation letters, attendance muster, all these are very much required. Sending the staff for orientation courses, refresher course, short-term course, taking care of its promotion under CAS as per rules generates that attachment towards the institution. There are several leaves. We have mentioned a few. In Delhi University, I was told that there is something called gestation leave. There are also casual leaves, medical leave, sabbatical, maternity, paternity, duty leave, extraordinary leave. So these have to be granted as and depending upon the situation. Then the service book of the employees has to be updated every year. They have to be provided form number 16. The PF has to be deducted. And the employees who retire, we have to see that their pension papers or pension files are already processed and they get their pension and gratuity in time. At least from the college end, there should not be any delay. This can really add to the safety and security immeasurably. Criteria 7 deals with institutional values and best practices. The best practices followed by the institution should be documented and reviewed every year. The distinctiveness of an institution enhances its reputation. There should be, the practice of institutionalizing yoga and meditation for the staff that can add to their physical and mental well-being. The course on human values instills values of cooperation, discipline, harmony, and tolerance. Sustainable environment is the focus of NAC, and most of the colleges are taking steps to promote sustainable environment. Audits are extremely necessary to validate our existing procedures, detect lacunae, and offer valuable suggestions. Colleges have to be prepared academic audit, financial audit, gender audit, energy audit, environment audit, and even structural audit. These documents have to be in place before the NAC visit. In recent times, cybersecurity has emerged of prime importance. Safeguarding data, protecting files, cloud storage, backup on servers, all these have tremendous importance. Students have to be made aware of cyber crimes through guest lectures. Now, many in this lockdown period, most of the colleges are resorting to online admissions even for their first year classes. Students sometimes face glitches when they have to do payment. So they just reached their payment link and they are not able to do. Sometimes they are not able to register on the page. So these issues have to be addressed immediately. The website of a college is the mirror of the college. So there has to be a policy regarding uploading the content on the website. Who should be given that authority? It should not be given to all. So there has to be a website committee which will update the website. Then as now most of the teachers are undertaking online teaching, and we know that they do face a lot of difficulties. It is not just the students, but also the teachers. So when they are shifted to online teaching, the colleges need to provide them facilities for that. in the college, like you can provide laptops, comfortable chairs, and even equipments to make videos. You can provide them mics, and the internet connection has to be really sound so that there is no issue of internet connectivity. And even students need to be given breaks during between two lectures because they need to log in. So cyber security also has now become very much important. Waste management is also important from the point of view of environment, and NAC attaches a lot of importance to it. So the segregation of waste, disposal of waste, solid waste, liquid waste, electronic waste is also to be looked into. Even the electronic waste, you can dispose it off by giving it to a vendor. Then the vermicompost pits play an important role when it comes to conservation of environment. We have also included this slide because now we call what is the new normal in times of COVID. So the safety and security, which now the colleges have to observe in the times of corona pandemic, such as social distancing, spraying of disinfectants, making it compulsory to wear masks, provision of face shields, thermal guns, sanitizers, pulse oximeter, staggering of duty hours for the office staff, even for the teachers, is required. And many a times when students face connectivity issues, they are not able to hear the lectures. So the recording of those lectures has to be provided on LMS. Though we have taken here the example only of corona pandemic, we are also aware that there are other diseases, like for example, dengue. It really causes havoc. So regular fogging is required during the monsoon. Finally, I would like to conclude by saying that safety is not to be thought narrowly. Safety and security are intertwined. If we ignore them, we ignore them at our own risk, at our own peril. And the cost is really very huge. It's going to cost us in terms of enrollment, results, grants, recruitment, retention, relations with stakeholders, goodwill in the market, and reputation of the institution. But if we really pay attention to that, the benefit ultimately is the progress of the institution. I finally conclude by saying that our entire team believes that safety and security are not expensive, they are priceless. Thank you all. I really thank all the esteemed judges, IQAC cluster, Dr. Piyush Pahade, Dr. Badru Nisa, all participants and all anchors for their patient listening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, ma'am.
I don't see any questions in a box, but still it is open for the audience if they want to raise any question.
There can be one additional mention done over here, and that can be safety with respect to websites. A secure website is extremely important. It's not only that the information about the organization is going to be safe, but it's also about the safety of the students. Because students these days pay their money and their fees through the websites. So safe and secure website counts out. This can be an additional feature that an additional aspect that can be added. It possibly has got missed out.
Yeah, I mean, we took it as implicit. It's very well noted.
Sir, nowadays students also, sir, can you hear me?
Yes, please.
Yes.
Sir, nowadays students also work out blog sites of their own, which are sometimes attached to the departmental part of the website in institution. I always believe that this also has to be carefully monitored because this can create havoc in terms of unmonitored material which can go into a college website. Mm-hmm. So there has to be a policy and a system in place which monitors and at the same time enhances the content quality of the website. Which right. Makes again the institution.
Yes,
very
true. Yeah. Very true. Is Shinde sir here? Yes, Shinde sir is here. Okay. Sumanta Swami, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please go ahead.
I guess so, I have completed in time.
Yes, yes.
I did not want to overstep because I know there is another presentation which wants to follow.
So,
sir, Dr. Anshu is asking, what about the safety and security of the disabled or the physically challenged people? I think we have taken it up in our presentation.
Yes, it has been mentioned.
We have mentioned it, but of course, both physical infrastructural facilities that have to be provided and taken care of, as well as their psychological and sociological integration within the larger body polity of the institution is very important. And policies and mechanisms have to be there, in both, in every aspect, in the classroom, in the library, in the administration, everywhere. They must not feel separate or different. They have to be a part of the institution.
So with this, may I now request our today's chief judges for the session, Dr. Bhalchandra Bhole sir and Dr. Manjula Raja madam, to give their expert comments on the presentation. Bhole sir. Or even Manjula madam, Dr. Manjula madam, you can start.
Sir, I'm waiting for Dr. Balachandran. That
okay. Yeah, sir is there, yeah.
Yeah.
Presentation. I had written some things down, but they are very well covered here. I just wanted to mention two more things after Pahade sir said. I was going to mention website, but he said that. I think the what everything was aimed at was mental security. The mental security of all the stakeholders, if it is taken into consideration, then everything that we have said really points to that, number one. And the other two things which I wanted to say was security with respect to copyrights and patents. Because nowadays we see that there is a lot of copyright and patent plagiarism through our own websites. And therefore, the website security becomes a very big issue. So copyrights and patents, I think you have mentioned the research, but copyrights and patents also will require a lot of security aspects. And this security aspect with respect to copyrights would directly be related to the IPR and innovation part, you know, those workshops that we conduct are expected to conduct under innovation, then those copyright and patents part also should be included in security. Else everything was really nice, and Dr. Samant said right in the beginning that though security may have seemed like a very offhanded and handed down topic by Pahade sir, I don't think so. Pahade sir does that. He thinks a little bit over, and he always, I think, leaves the cream to the last, and it comes to the top, and that is what today's presentation was. And I would really appreciate Dr. Swati madam's presentation and Dr. Amrapali's contribution to the same. Thank you so much. Over to you, Raja madam.
Thank you, sir. As per the title goes, safety and security in the academic criteria. So they have covered almost all the aspects. As rightly said by doctor, should have included more about the emotional aspects. But other than that, the rest of the things are very well organized. That's it.
Thank you, madam. So with this, we conclude the first session of the day and the last presentation of this national webinar as far as the participation's contribution is concerned. May I now request Dr. Varsha madam to take over for the second session of the day.
Thank you so much, Dr. Somni, and thank you to Team 7 for their excellent presentation also. So we move on, as I said, to the next session of the day. And in this session, we are going to have a talk by a very experienced principal on the topic of the scheme that their college has ranked, has been granted. So innovation, entrepreneurship, incubation, make in India, all these are very buzzwords of today, especially in the education and the business sector. And Honorable Prime Minister of India has also declared this decade as the decade of innovation to unleash the creative potential of every Indian. And India has already been improving on this this area of innovation and entrepreneurship in the global stage. And we have risen from the 57th place to the, from the 86th place to the 57th place in the last 5 years. So for India to emerge as a global innovation hub, the youth of the country play a very major role, the youth, especially from the higher education institutions. Because they are the ones who are going to be the ones who will take our country towards self-sustenance. And naturally, then the higher education institutes have to create or provide a sustainable innovation ecosystem to them, something that will encourage, inspire, and nurture the young students and will expose them to new ideas and processes that will finally result or culminate into some great innovations, especially for a country that is rising up in the business sector. So to encourage this, the Ministry of Human Resource Development of Government of India has launched a scheme called as the Atal Ranking of Institutions on Innovation Achievements, ARIIA, as it is called. And this under the scheme, government is systematically ranking all major higher educational institutions and universities in India on the indicators that are related to innovation and entrepreneurship development on the amongst the students and the faculties. So this ranking is done on in six categories: centrally funded institutions, then state funded universities, state-funded autonomous institutions, deemed universities, private institutions, women's only educational institutes, or there are six such categories that they have formed. And it is basically through this that through the scheme, ARIIA wants to orient the mindset and build ecosystems to encourage high quality research, innovation, and entrepreneurship. So to tell us more about this scheme, we have, as I said, the principal of one such ranked institution, Vidya Pratishthan's Arts, Science and Commerce College, Baramati, Pune. So I request my colleague, Ms. Elizabeth, to please introduce Principal Bharat Shinde, who's going to talk on this topic. Over to you, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Dr. Varsha. Dr. Bharat Shinde, Principal, Vidya Pratishthan Arts, Science and Commerce College, Baramati. Sir has, to his credit, an array of awards. The Botany Silver Jubilee Gold Medal, Dr. T.S. Mahabale Gold Medal by Savitribai Phule Pune University, Best Teacher Award in the year 2011, Cross Disciplinary Award from Suranya Education Institution, Bangalore, 2018. Under his leadership, his college has received a grant of rupees 70 lakhs in the year 2016. The college has been conferred the status of Star College and received a grant of rupees 79 lakhs from BBT New Delhi, RUSA grant of rupees 200 lakhs from UGC in the year 2019-20. Ladies and gentlemen, the list of Sir's achievement is exhaustive. 100 research publications, 24 books published at national and international level. May I request Sir to take over the session and share his experience with us about Atal Yojana. Thank you, Sir.
Principal Shinde, sir,
this, sir?
Yes, may we request Bharat Shinde, sir, to unmute himself and start the presentation?
Amit, sir?
Yes, I am giving a call.
Okay.
Till then, can we ask Manjula madam to give her feedback on this, because she may leave by 6:30 as she is having some other session with her vice chancellor in university. If sir is not ready, can we tell Manjula?
Definitely, ma'am, definitely. Manjula ma'am, can you give us some feedback on
Thank you, Dr. Bhadranesa, and thank you, Dr. Vashya. So, like, first of all, I would like to thank the entire team for inviting me to this session. Though I had been working in the universities as well as a
unmute. Okay.
Hello. Yeah, shall I proceed?
Yes.
Okay. I felt like the sessions are really good, but sometimes I feel maybe I have missed other sessions also. But the first session was really interesting, and it has covered almost all the aspects which a particular institution has to follow. And I wish that the second session would go on with the same
extent. Hello?
About inputs to the...
am I audible? Hello?
Yes, sir. Can we give ma'am a minute so she can finish? Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Okay.
Just 2 minutes, sir. Hindi, sir.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thank you. So I wish the team that it should go on well, and the rest of the shares feedback details I would be sharing with Dr. Bhadranesa. Once again, I thank you, the entire team, for providing me this opportunity.
Thank you, Manjula.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, Dr. Manjula, to be there with us today in your busy schedule.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam.
So, Principal Shinde?
Yes.
Yes, sir, you can please
good evening.
Yes. Thank you.
Amit, I have mailed you my PPT.
Okay, sir. Shall I share? I'll stop your sharing then.
Yeah.
Okay. Give me a minute. I'm just opening your file.
Okay. Or shall I share from my laptop?
Sir, whatever that is convenient. Otherwise, I also...
Okay, you can.
Okay, sir. Just a minute. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Respected dignitaries,
all participants
and my dear friends. You all know that recently Atal ranking of institutions on innovation achievements has declared result. So our college was one of them. Next, please. I hope there are almost 9 parameters. We will see one by one in detail. Next. Next, please. Yes. Yeah. The weightage is given here, maximum score allotted per parameter. It is from 2.5 to max 32. So here you can see the total of 100. So next. Next slide, please.
Should I go one more slide plus, sir?
Yeah, okay. This is about Global Innovation Index. So we were somewhere on 81th position in 2015. And in 2018, our rank was 52. Next, please. Yeah, this is parameter number one. There are various programs and activities which are conducted in particular institute, such as IPR, innovation, startup, and entrepreneurship organized. There are two parts. Part one generally includes programs conducted by institute, which are related to IPR, entrepreneurship, startups, and innovation. I think they have considered the data for the financial year 2018-19. The second part was participation or representation of students or faculty in events, programs related to IPR, entrepreneurship, startups, and innovation organized by reputed external institutions or agencies at national or international level. I think we have data sheets given. How many of the, your students and teachers participated? Then how many programs you have conducted in your institute? How many students and faculties you have sent outside your campus? What was the budget? These are the things actually which we have to include in the data. Then parameter two, annual budget spent on innovation and startup funding. Next, please. Next slide.
Yes, sir, I'm on parameter three and six. Maybe it is taking time to
look. Yes. Yeah, so parameter three and six, pre-incubation and incubation infrastructure, successful innovation and startups, and funding, expenses and income from innovation and startups during the financial year 2018-19. Here part one is innovation, pre-incubation, and incubation center facilities and services. Part one, innovation, pre-incubation, and incubation center facilities which exist in campus. I think there are room sizes, then how many facilities are there? These things are very important. Part B is grants, funds received by pre-incubation and incubation center facilities which exist on the campus. Then part C, the idea or prototype or innovation have received grant funding from pre-incubation or incubation center or facilities. Then part 1D, generally startups have received grant funding from pre-incubation, incubation center facilities, etc. Next, please. Yeah, this is about parameter four, courses on innovation, IPR, and entrepreneurship development offered by institute during academic period. Then parameter five, IP granted and published. Then technology transfer and its commercialization. So here, number of patents granted and published are very important. Then technology commercialization or transfer of technology is important. Next. So these were parameters taken into account to declare the ranks. Now, there are two broad categories in rank categorization. A is publicly funded institutions, and B, private or self-financed institutions. In publicly funded institutions, there were three subcategories: Institute of National Importance, Central Universities, CFTIs, number two, State University, and Deemed Universities, which are government and government aided. And third subcategory is government and government or aided colleges or institutes. Yeah, our college is aided college. So we were in this category. Then in private or self-financed institutions, private or self-financed universities. Next. So this is the summary. Almost 674 higher educational institutes under different categories have participated in ARIA 2020. So here colleges or institutes which belong to government or government aided, the count was 121. Colleges / institutes which are private or self-financed, I see the number 373. Institute of National Importance and Central Universities, 62. University and deemed to be university, 38, and university and deemed to be university private or self-funded, around 80. Next. I hope you have enjoyed this webinar. From criteria 1 to criteria 7, the interlinking is very important. Outcome is very important, process is important, and input is also important. So these people from MHRD, now we can say Ministry of Education, ME, they are very talented. They have divided these parameters into input parameters, then process parameters, and output parameters. You can see the score, around 25.5% weightage was given to input parameters, 34.5% process parameters, and about 40% weightage is given to output parameters. They are interlinked with each other. So one can check programs on IPR, innovation and startup, organized and participated. So if you have your curriculum rich with all these activities, well and good. If you don't have, you can include those, organize, train, and motivate the young researchers. Then next part is annual budget spent on innovation and startup funding. Income and expenditure. So this is also important. I think all directors, principals are worried about the budget. So you have to like spend from college account if you don't get fundings. If your ideas are good, you have to spend initially from your pocket. Once you have $1 million worth idea, then automatically funding will come to your institute. Next one, innovation, pre-incubation, incubation, and infrastructure facilities established. I think our institute is one of the best which has state-of-art facilities. I am very proud to say that in February, there was international committee. They visited our campus and they told university authorities that why don't you have shown this institute since 2 years we are visiting India. It was none other than University of Melbourne team. They were interested to start blended BSc program in our college collaboration. Then awards and recognition of students and faculty for innovation and startups in various competitions or contests events conducted. Courses on IPR, innovation startup offered by institute, then IP granted and published. So I think you have to file patents. You can publish them. So maybe Indian and international patents also. And the last part is output parameters. Here, successful innovations supported, then produced and startups established. These are very important. I think 25% weightage is there out of 100. Then seed fund, angel and venture fund support raised by above startups and innovations, and technology transfer and commercialization. Next. So I was telling you about various, again, weightages. So programs and activities on IPR, innovation, startup, and entrepreneurship, almost 7.5% marks. Pre-incubation and incubation infrastructure and facilities to support I and E. Next one, same weightage. Annual budget spent on promoting and supporting innovation and entrepreneurship activities, 13 marks. Then courses on innovation, IPR, entrepreneurship development. I think autonomous institutes, they have upper hand here. Ours is affiliated college. We are conducting periodically IPR workshops. Then intellectual property, technology transfer, and commercialization. Almost 32% marks. Next. Yeah, those six parameters were important. So parameter one, number of programs conducted, number of program participated, and number of awards received. So out of 7.5, they have given equal credit to these three parameters. Next. Yeah, parameter three, part A, number of centers, type of facility wise, then carpet area. So here 0.25 into 5. If your pre-incubation center is like less or equal to 600 square feet, then you can get 0.25 mark. So you can imagine the competition. If you have this, then you can get same. Otherwise, I think you can lose the marks. Next. Parameter 6, part 1C, number of innovations, 0 to 4, will get 2% score. Here, if the range is between 5 to 7, then you can get 3. And number of innovations between 8 to 9, you can get 9%. So you can see, if you have 4, 50% of top, then you are getting 20% marks. If you have almost 70%, then you can get 33% marks. And if you are in top two, then you can get additional 66%. I think this was the tough competition. So those institutes who were in top five, I think they were in the last tier. Next. Parameter three, giving incubation, receiving incubation. So if you have incubator, I think you can allow your students. You can also receive external agencies to incubate your incubation center. So the weightage is 2.5. Then parameter six, part 1C. Next. Number of full-time programs, number of short-time and elective or core credit, number of MDP, EDP, FDP programs. See, 1% is very important. If you don't conduct, then you cannot get the score. Same thing is short-time or elective or core credit. So I think for parameter 4, 5% weightage was there. Next. Then patent granted, patent published, incubated, startup holds patent, weightage is there. So 27%. Then IP and technology commercialization. I think here there is 10% weightage. Number of IPs granted, number of IPs published. Next. Next slide, please. Then last, total revenue or income from innovation, IPR and startup and incubation. Total income from incubation, training and skill mentoring, office space and rent, etc. 2.5% score. Total revenue for technology or IP commercialization, again 2.5. So subtotal is 5. And total of this parameter is 13. So here, these were 100 marks. Next. So I think our accuracy coordinator was very smart. She took care of each and every event organized, documented very well, enlisted number of participants, programs, beneficiaries, funds collected, spent in detail, and the balance sheet should match income and expenditure. You have to upload audited statement. I think from publicly funded institution, top ranked institutes, top 10, you can see here all IITs, IIT Madras, Bombay, Delhi, Institute of Science, then IIT Kharagpur, Kanpur, Mandi. Next. Next slide, please. Government and government-aided universities, Institute of Chemical Technology, Punjab University, then Chaudhary Charan Singh, Haryana Agriculture University, Anand Agriculture University, Periyar University. Next. Next slide, please. Yeah, this is government and government-aided college oblique institutes. College of Engineering, Pune, then PES College of Engineering, Coimbatore Institute of Technology. So I think these are top five. Our college was in same group, band A. The rank was in between 6 to 25. Next. Self-financed, band B. that is private or self-financed universities. So you are here, Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology, Korda, SRM Institute of Technology, Vellore Institute of Technology. So these were five top-ranked higher educational institutes. Next. South India is dominating in all the categories and subcategories. Next slide. And this was fifth subcategory, private or self-financed colleges or institutes. And the last one is the special category. I think this year they have introduced the educational institutions exclusively for women, only from government and government-aided category. So there were two institutes, that is, one was from Tamil Nadu and other one was from Delhi. Next. If you want to see the reports, you can go to websites of these universities and colleges. Entire 11 to 20 pages RER report is uploaded. So you can see app. I think most of your colleges and institutes might have spent to organize this, but we failed to file in competition. So NAC says that whether you have filed for NIRF ranking, RER ranking, NBA, etc. So here you can see our college. This is our AISHE code, C41926, Vidya Pratishthan Arts, Science and Commerce College. Next. Next, please. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. There aren't any questions in the QA box.
There is one question.
Yeah, there is only one question in the chat box. So the question says that we are interested to know and apply for this this ARIIA. When the portal is likely to open, and when and we want an expert guidance from you. So that we can apply for this.
Yeah, you have to continuously see all these things. So generally, I think it was in the month of September, October. November was last date.
Yes, yes.
To upload all those things.
Answered. Yes,
yes. I am proud of my coordinator, NAC coordinator. She replied all these things during lockdown time in the month of April. She was coming to my office and saying that, sir, these are the queries raised. We have to answer them. Today is last date. Even she has not taken my consent to file application. She was ready, prepared everything, and told me that we would like to file this application. I said, no problem. You can go ahead. So you should have a wonderful IQSE coordinator. I think Nilima Pendarkar is attending this webinar. Even for this webinar, she has not taken my permission. I have given her freedom. Whenever you want to excel, learn new things, bring the good ideas which were discussed in variety of such a webinars, share your ideas with our faculty, management, and stakeholders, conduct programs, and like excel our institute. Ours is the only rural college. We are located at Taluka Place.
Yes, sir. In fact, I wanted to ask you a question in this regard itself. You know, when we were seeing the list of colleges that have got ranking, almost I think 95% of them were engineering colleges or colleges that are into science and technology. So I just wanted to ask you, like, for a college which is into arts, commerce, and science, how do you really, you know, encourage entrepreneurship in your college? You must have been doing a lot of activities in this regard. So can you maybe give us some idea as to how these your expert ideas, because how we can look at for colleges like ours, you know, who are arts, science and commerce colleges?
Yeah. Madam, we have got funding from DBT Star. So we have purchased very nice instruments. We have appointed some in charges people. We have shouldered responsibility to them, and you can conduct projects, publish them. Then you can also allow other college students and teachers, researchers to conduct some of the research work. Similarly, we have DST FIST funding. Then we have established central research facility. And I request, by chance, if you get opportunity, you should definitely visit our School of Biotechnology. It is one of the best institute. I think the finance minister 2 years back visited. I forgot his name. He like died, but he said, if we have such institutes in rural part of India, if we have 100 such institutes, India will shift from developing nations list to developed countries.
That's really commendable, sir.
Yeah.
Very commendable. Hearty congratulations to
Thank you,
you for
Thank
getting
you.
This ranking. Yeah. Do any of the other panelists like to ask questions? Pahade, sir.
Yes, sir, thank you so much. I called you at a very short notice, but I thought this was a good podium. We are preparing people for quality, and quality has benchmarks. Some of them are in numericals. Some come in terms of quality. Some come in terms of quantity. Since you have measured one of those benchmarks, I think so that's the best way to put you in front of the team, so that your organization is seen by the world. And our participants know this new Atal Yojana, and they also participate and promote to the development of the nation. So with this, now let us start with the final ceremony. Varsha, I hand over the mic back to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Principal Shinde. Thank you for giving us a complete idea about how all the scoring happens. I now request my colleague, Ms. Elizabeth Kanade, to take over for the valedictory function. We have come to an end to the of the 4-day national seminar. So, Ms. Kanade, can you please take over now?
Thank you, Dr. Varsha. We now proceed to the valedictory function, where the effort of all the team members and our mentors has come to an end, but the journey still continues. It is the culmination of our hard work, efforts, teamwork, what you saw in this national webinar. I now request Dr. Suman to introduce our chief guest for the valedictory function.
Thank you, Dr. Kanade, madam. I believe personally it is one of the greatest days in my life to have with us today Dr. R.M. Chitnis as the chief guest for the valedictory function. He is the Pro Vice Chancellor of MIT University, Pune. Initially, he did his MBS, then postgraduate diploma in business management, MPhil, and also PhD. As far as professional career is concerned, he started with National Institute of Banking. Later on, he joined the Modern College, then Institute of Management. And since 2011, he is with MIT University. So personally, I feel it's a very diverse exposure he has gathered in the tenure of his professional career, which must have not only enriched him, but he must have translated that enrichment to other institutions wherever and whenever capacity he has served that. In MIT, on the basis of his sheer quality and dedication, he has climbed the ladders, which is otherwise very difficult for many people to cover up that distance in such a short period of time. Initially, he joined there as a principal, then he became a dean, then provost, and at present he is working as honorable pro vice chancellor. He is also associated with University of Pune, which is now known as Savitribai Phule Pune University. He is there in various capacities as member of board of studies. He is also a member of affiliation committee there. He was several times on the selection panel and selection committee of the university, and he's also there a member of academic council. He has 11 books in his credit and a remarkable publication with many, many research papers in renowned national and international journals. As far as NAAC parameter is concerned, we often come across with one term called functional MOUs. And I'm really impressed, rather delighted to know. And then naturally it indicates the kind of persona we are having with us today, because he has been instrumental in ensuring, and at present, because of his sheer leadership, there are as many as 25 functional MOUs in MIT. He is a NAAC peer team member, and also very proud to say that he is also a reviewer of QS ranking, which is slowly gradually taking momentum in India. And many higher educational institutions are now even going for this QS ranking also. His visionary insight to the educational field has taken him beyond the boundaries of this country. And what a great contribution he has done. He has contributed in establishing many summer schools beyond India in a country like USA, Australia, France, Netherlands, and even Sweden. He has traveled extensively throughout the world. He is also associated with National University of Singapore, Singapore Management University, and Nanyang Technological University. No wonder then he is awarded aptly by several organizations. He was also chosen as a best principal, and there is also an award to his credit for his educational management. I therefore personally feel that we all are extremely lucky to have among us such a visionary, able administrator, and above all, a great educationist. Sir, the journey you have chosen, the distance you have covered, the milestones you have achieved, and the impressive impact you are leaving behind at every stage of your professional responsibility is extremely inspirational and remarkable to us. We indeed feel very blessed today to have you with us, and we are extremely eager to listen to your golden words. Vice Chancellor Dr. R.M. Chitnis. Sir, the stage
is
yours.
Thank you, Dr. Soni, for gracious introduction. And it's my pleasure to join you, and it's an honor and privilege to be in such an august body of innovative professors. I was listening to the entire presentation done about the security aspect and the policy. And I came to know that wonderful innovations are done by this group. And today I feel that I should have attended all the sessions, and I would have certainly been benefited. At the outset, I'm grateful to Dr. Sanjay Kharat sir, principal of Modern College, a colleague and a good friend who has invited me here, and to Dr. Pahade, who is also one of the organizers of this particular activity. Dr. Kharat sir, may I express my gratitude towards you for considering me in this important occasion. And I express gratitude to all others, those who are listening this particular entire seminar or webinar incessantly. And I was watching if there is a dropout in the attendee. And I see that it was going up. It was 64 and now it is 84. Normally at the end, people start dropping out. And that is the real quality Dr. Pahade, Dr. Kharat has mentioned. Dr. Kharat told me that I work in NACPEER team at all levels. I started as a member of peer review. Then I became a member secretary. And because of my designation, I became chairman. Different experiences. But then today, with your permission, Dr. Kharat sir, I'm choosing slightly different topic related to this activity, but how the things are happening at the global level. I will take 5 to 6 minutes and hopefully all of you will have some kind of a delight in listening to me. So first of all, there are multiple accreditations model, various accreditation model. And they could be something like ACSB or maybe ECWIS or EMBA, or there are many, there are 26, 27 accreditation bodies which are regularly doing this work. If you want, I can share you the list later. So which accreditation is good? My appeal to all of you, since I'm perceiving you as real innovators and those who are agents of change, I feel that you will bring in a lot of change in the existing NAC accreditation module also. If you look at accreditation started by Dr. Nigvekar sir then, many years back, many decades back, and the accreditation model or the framework or the SSR report or the structure, there is a great change happening. So what is the outcome of today's webinar is all these faculty members, principals, deans, those who are participating today, they can become assessors of NAC, and NAC is always looking for such learned and innovative faculty members. To me, in addition to this, I want to add that not only NAC model, but all such accreditation model, if you can look at it and see that you take best of the best from each accreditation model. That's the first point. Second point is when we go in India for accreditation, we have two options. One is NAC, and if you don't want to go for NAC, then you have NBA, National Board of Accreditation, especially courses under AICT. So if you look at both the structures, then you will see there is a difference between NAC structure and NBA structure. Let us not say which is good, which is not so good. We assume that all international 30 models are good and all NBA and NAC, both the models are good or the structures are good. But if you look at the salient features and try to look at the difference between that, then NAC offers grade and NBA doesn't offer grade. And many of you would be doing both the accreditations, must be knowing both the accreditations. So next time when we meet, we can discuss, is it a good idea to give someone grade? Is it a good idea to say you are A, you are B, you are C, you are D? Probably yes, probably no. But that can be discussed. Because at a point of time in Pune, 30 colleges go for NAC. So some get A plus, some get A, some get B, C, D, like that. Like that today, 12th merit list is top. Should we go ahead with this kind of a gradation system, or we should go for NBA who do not give grade, but they give only accreditation for 3 years and 5 years based on the marks? I know many of you will like NAC model and many of you may like NBA model. So all models are good. Second is, when it comes to giving accreditation, you make a time frame that you are accredited now for next 5 years, but that is NAC. not that all accreditations model are saying it for 5 years. So that is also can be discussed. I'm not saying arguing or debating. I'm not saying that. I'm only saying discussing. So you go for NBA, it could be 3 years also. You may get a 3 years accreditation, maybe 2 years earlier. Earlier it used to be 2 years. If you look at three top ratings, that is EQUIS, EMBA, and AACSP. If you look at the tenure of the accreditation, time frame given, or validity is also different. One is 4 years, one is 2 years, and one is 12 months to 18 months. So which is correct? So let us all discuss this. The next is NAC gives institutional gradation and NBA gives program wise. For example, one engineering college has 5 programs or one university has different programs. Then you will have to go for a separate accreditation. If you go by NBA route, but if you go by NAC, then a composite kind of a grading is made available, which is correct is not the issue, but let us discuss the way ahead. And I'm coming to the same point when I complete second point, NAC versus MBA or, you know, different models. You are the agent of change. You are the innovators. You have done wonderful policies. So you can take a task and then write to NAC or MHRD that these are the changes required. We should not take the existing SSR as it is for next n number of years. That is the second point. I don't want to go into nitty-gritties like NAC charges are lower and NBA charges are higher. So NBA charges are higher and per program you have to pay. So engineering college has to pay 5 lakh into 5 or 7, 35 lakh rupees, and NAC can be done in 1 and 5. So many AICT approved people are coming to NAC. This is one of the shortcut for reducing the fee or charges. Should we connect these grading to the rating? You are aware that we have a grading accreditation system and we have a rating system. When it comes to rating system, we have 3 international and 1 national. We have Times Higher Education rating system, QS rank, that is ranking system, I'm talking. I was introduced as one of the peer reviewer for the QS ranking. So altogether a different format. Now QS and Shanghai, if you go to Shanghai, it is pretty tough. Now you will ask me why you are putting today ranking system in the accreditation discussion. That's the next point. That's the fourth point. All of you are well versed by this time about the 64 pages NEP policy, National Education Policy 2020. It will become a bill. It will be implemented. There will be back and forth changes happening. But let me share with you idea of Dr. Kasturi Rangan, whom I heard personally, that henceforth NAC accreditation and NRF rating will be closely monitored. On that basis, funding will be given. UGC, which stands for University Grants Commission, who gives grants, will be now looking into these two rankings, that is NAC. But NAC, they will look at it different way. NAC has an overemphasis now, not from the, let us keep aside funding. But all of you, those who are young professors, you will see that entire academic institutions or the network or the university and colleges, higher education institutes, HEI, will be divided into 3 areas. One area is national level research universities. Second is national level teaching universities. And third is autonomous college. So by 2035, those who get A+, they will be out of affiliation and they will go. You are aware about that. But are you aware that they will have to go for NIRF also? And if they are into top 100, their funding will go. Of course, we can challenge this both ways. Dr. Kasturi Rangan is saying so, but tomorrow some people may object that XYZ is a non-aided college and NIRF ranking is high. Dr. Bharat Shinde was showing that from Tamil Nadu, there are some private players who are having very high rating in Atal Innovation. Right now, there is a talk going on that even if you are a private and your ratings are very high, so top such 50 or 20, they will be getting grants. Is it correct? We really don't know. what is correct or what. But I'm just opening a Pandora box in front of you. Do you mean by that those who are aided, their support, their financial grants will come down and will be going to private? Let us keep this aside because that will lead to another, you know, discussion as such. Next is, I want to attract your organization, where this particular, your attention to quality assurance organizations, because you are a group of people, those who are not only innovative, but agents of change, but they are ready to grasp new things and ready to incorporate it, whatever is happening in the day-to-day activities of the college or higher education. What do I mean by that? We have seen accreditation bodies like ECWIS, EMBA, and EBATE is another. There are four major now, ECWIS, EMBA, EBATE, and AACSB. In India, we have NAC and BA. So we can look for that, connect it to NRF kind of a ranking, which is known as QS ranking, Shanghai ranking, and Times Higher Education ranking. But do not stop there. Connect it to the higher education quality assurance agencies. Many of you would be knowing this, but for benefit of those who are not aware, let me share with you that there could be multiple agencies. INQAHE is very popular because our Jagannath Patil NAC advisor is a member and he was a chairman. INQAHE is there, then you have ASQ is there, then you have Japan Quality Society, where now Jagannath Patil has gone on deputation. Then you have National Academic Praise. Lot of quality organizations are there. My appeal to all of you, let us all take membership. I'm also not yet member, but I'm invited for a couple of times. But let's take membership and create our network, it at least in Southeast Asia, and see that we are Indians who will dominate and then overpower our Chinese competitors. And then there is no competition in South Asia for us, maybe Singapore. And that is possible. And I have gone through the membership fees, which is just around 5,000 rupees or 7,000 rupees. And then voting takes place. Right now, Indian members are very low. And that is what Dr. Patil told me once. Now coming, that suppose we keep aside all this, ECWIS, EMBA, EBATE. I'm saying these names again because AACSB is for all, ECWIS and EMBA is for management, commerce, and EBATE is for engineering. So if we keep aside QS ranking, if we keep aside INQAHE and keep aside NBA also, and just concentrate on SSR of NAC right now, very sharp focus, then what changes? Dr. Pahade sir, my appeal to you is there can be many changes. I'm not saying right now it is not up to the mark. It is up to the mark. But as and when time passes, we need to make change. And this your group is the right group with the right perspective to make changes. Without any such argument, I want to put in some of the areas where we can make some changes. One of them is attendance. I have spoken it earlier, but then I was asked to keep quiet on this. Do we have daily attendance incorporated in SSR? So you will see many colleges are getting high grade where students not at all there. It's like giving a restaurant 5-star grade, 4-star grade, or 3-star where no customer is there. Where is the attendance in the college? But let's cut that point because it is slightly, you know, may not be liked by many of them in the NAC. The second could be the corona pandemic has given birth to the different kind of a technology which we are watching, which we are using and watching each other. So can we have even NEP, NBA, and NAC redesign their policies? I'm saying even NEP, sir, with respect to use of technology, but not the technology like computer, laptop, the technology like what we are talking, what we are using right now. And my appeal to all of you that tomorrow when we are stopping all the Chinese apps, can we say no to such apps which we are using or software like Zoom or WebEx or Microsoft Teams and maybe Skype? Can we say no? And then thereby we have our own softwares. So tomorrow Bharat software I'm using like that. Thik, it can happen in next 10 years. And that would be one of the criteria in going for accreditation. Can we have a national grid? Like we have large highways being built, 20,000 crore rupees Mumbai Pune highway, just 200 rupees you can become user of that. And we have a national grid of knowledge where all the courses are put up, videos are available, syllabus is available, books are available. And each college can use that grid. And if you have 3,000 students, you have 500 students, you have 1 lakh students, accordingly, pro rata, we can use that particular knowledge grid. So one is network system when we teach. Second is national knowledge grid. And third could be, in that case, a ERP system, where right from admission to final degree, it could be standardized. And then you don't have to babble around the word about the digital divide and rural versus urban. In Gadchiroli, in Pune, Deccan, Gymkhana, you'll get separate because 4G is available everywhere. And tomorrow could be 5G. It may not be possible. That is what some of you think. I think it is possible. You have a great, very dynamic minister. You take a PPE, public, private, special purpose vehicle and 20, 30,000 crore rupees. And bringing some software companies together like Infosys or Wipro, whichever you want. And entire India will dominate Southeast Asia and tomorrow world. So I'm just trying to pull out this wonderful group from the NAC SSR to that through this. So attendance will go up if you are online. It could be flexible weightage system. I have spoken in NAC during the change of this report. That you go to Indapur, you go to Baramati, you go to Nasik, you go to Pune, Mumbai, even everywhere the NAC weightages are saved. And some of them may not be knowing how to do that. And thereby they try to manipulate it. Why manipulation comes? Because of the ignorance. Of course, there are many other issues also why we do manipulation. But one of them is problem. I have a problem with this particular question, 4.3.3. That means ignorance of knowledge. I've also gone on board with NAC when Dr. D.P. Singh was there as a NAC chairman, who is a UGC chairman today. How about submitting the NAC SSR in vernacular language? Someone comes from Ahmednagar, he can submit in Marathi. Or someone comes from Punjab, Jalandhar can in Punjabi, someone comes from Tamil Nadu. So some changes I'm trying to look at. Are we giving any weightage to NEP's NRF right now? National Research Foundation with 20,000 crore rupees per kitty and 1% of GDP. Do you know what is 1% of GDP? It's going to be a huge amount, near lakh of crore or 87,000. So put together, if that goes into research, it is a good idea. But how you are going to accreditate such institutions? If you are three-layer institution, so you'll have three-layer criteria, three-layer SSR. You can't have one SSR and go around India in rural, semi-urban and urban with three-layer higher education institutes. I think my time is not told to me, but if I go on, I will have to, there was no specific time given to me, but it's a dinner time for many of you. So I go to next 2 points and stop. NAC is actually culture. Like you have a milk and then you have a curd culture and then it becomes a nice dahi or curd tomorrow. It's a culture. It is not SSR. It is not what all we try to do with the committee. When we go, we feel so shy that so many people are receiving you. For what? Is that required? So NAC is a culture actually. Can we build it? There are very few colleges where culture of NAC is there. It is more of a punishment. It is more of a division of work. So first thing NAC should do is make it compulsory, though all the 200 faculties working or 50 faculties or 5 faculties working in college, all 7 criteria they should know by heart. Gone are the days when my one team is criteria 1, criteria 2, criteria 3. That you do for delegation of labor or delegation of work. But that doesn't mean you are not master of the rest of them. It is not jack of all, but it is jack of all and master of one. So you pick up any criteria, you become master, you be jack of all. That is NAC culture. And like, very humbly, I want to say that there is a scheme for spreading the culture of research in STRIDE category one. STRIDE, you are aware, STRIDE 1, STRIDE 2, STRIDE 3, three things are there. The STRIDE 1 is spreading the culture of research. And incidentally, humbly, let me share that I'm one of the STRIDE UGC member at the Central Committee. Can we write to UGC? Of course, there are tidbits, some kind of small fund and activities available for spreading the culture of NAC. But through the highest body, UGC, each college will have, Pune University affiliated, each college will have compulsory program on introducing culture of NAC. You introduce the culture, remove the punishment from the minds of administration and minds of faculty members. And they will enjoy, like they have enjoyed online teaching with no time. Another thing I want to bring to Dr. Pahade's notice, sir, is if you look at NAC, it is primarily for five different values. One is national development, one is value system, one is global competencies. The five core, we call them V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. And then you have criteria. You can call them C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, 6, 7. Now in the row, you pick up an Excel sheet, and row one is V1, value system, contribution to the national development. Two is
mapping of
it. Yeah. Third is value system. Like that. And then you have seven criteria as a part of the column of the Excel sheet. So criteria one. And then you put your SSR, major salient thing, in that frame. I have done that for my organization. And then you come to know 7 multiplied by 5, 35 boxes you will have. Hardly 17, 16 boxes are full. Rest of the boxes we haven't done much. And there we start manipulating. And we really don't know if you take criteria 1 and core value 3, what can be done. It is embarrassing. And that's why we have to look at it. And then give this work to the young faculty members for brainstorming. They will enjoy it. Now, last but not the least, I want to thank Dr. Kharad, sir. You are there. And thank you very much for giving me this wonderful opportunity to interact with this. And you are my old colleague. You are my mentor. And we look forward for meeting you again. Dr. Pahade, sir, thank you. And my big thank you to Dr. Soni for gracious introduction. And I'm really happy that so many of you, 80 of you, are patiently listening to all the proceedings right from 5 p.m. till now, which is 10 minutes past 7 p.m. So I will definitely cherish these memories, this day in my life. May I say thank you. Jai Hind, Dhanyavad.
Thank you, sir. Varsha, madam.
Elizabeth, I think you were supposed to take over.
May I just speak for a second?
Yes, yes, sir. In fact, we wanted you to speak and talk a little bit more about the entire seminar.
Raviji, thank you so much for this, those wonderful questions that you have posed. They are really many things that we can really think about, and we are thinking about. For example, for a very long time in our mind we have why the attendance is not counted. And the second bigger question now that is coming up is post use of technology to such a large extent by all the universities, what will be the status of attendance? Because we have linked up this attendance, especially with respect to the government organizations, it is linked up to 80% of attendance is linked up to the examination and every aspect. With technology setting in and with lectures becoming a routine part with the help of technology, tomorrow this technology is going to stay here. So will those lectures continue, and how will the attendance be counted out? Every organization in a short while will be going up with LMSs. They will be having all their lectures coming up over there. on the LMS, and then how will that attendance matter out? So the questions are not there to end up, but definitely I'd like to meet you with respect to criteria versus values. This is one point. The second aspect that I wanted to say that what you said is what we are actually trying out for this particular webinar. We did not keep criteria. We cut down the criteria. We took a horizontal platform rather than a vertical one. The criteria are the vertical platforms. We have cut down the issues, and therefore it was teacher in NAC. So at like from criteria 1 to 7, where does the teacher stand? Or just as today you found out safety and security, which otherwise is related exclusively to criteria 4. How does it stand in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7? Or for that matter, how do various stakeholders interact with each other when we cross the criteria borders? And so many issues that we tried to, 7 issues that we tried to discuss out in these 7 teams. Your session was really, your talk was really very inspiring, and I have heard it very, very carefully, and I will be hearing it again and again. But I need time from you because I would like to talk to you in person. We'll also need a help from you in the future for IPC Coastal India. If we wish to reach all the parts of India, we are into 22 states plus today. And we will like to have your help, need your help, we need your assistance in the future also. These were the few words that I wanted to tell you.
Yes, my answer is always yes, I am available. One of the thing which I like is to tell about me is I am never busy. I am always well. There is a saying, I have a little informal relations with Dr. Karat. So I always say one of the dialogue of Amitabh Bachchan, hum to pakkad fakir kisam ke aadmi hai, humare paas khali waqt ke siwa kuch bhi nahi hai. So that is what
Chitni sir, thank you very much.
Yes. So Pandey sir, with your permission, just two small points in less than 30 seconds. One is that all the international accreditations, I'm not giving any opinion or side, are done by the Association of Education Institutes, not by the government. For example, AACSB is the topmost in United States of America. All the faculty, head of the department, deans, they all come together and their association does that. For EQUIS, EQUIS, it's a French, yes. And then EMBA is a European. So in that case, the association does that. Can we also have such associations like you, your association can do accreditation? That may not be formal, but at least this gives a stake. And second quick point is, if you look at AACSB accreditations, then normally, there are two levels, two visits are done. Here what happens, you submit SSR and then there is a suspense. What happened with your marks, digital marks. And secondly, team will come directly as a suspense. You be ready anytime. And team will go. Like we go from a particular college in Tamil Nadu, I come back to Pune, and then we submit online report to NAC. And then college is waiting, what will happen to me? And suddenly B plus, oh, we wanted A. Or suddenly A plus, we wanted A plus plus. Now that suspense is not a good idea when we talk of transparency. Thereby, I want to attract your attention to AACSB. AACSB, first year they train you. Third year, they give you rank particular, but that's an informal. They come to you in fourth year and fifth year final thing. So like we have in 12th exam, prelim, followed by the final exam. Here there is no prelim exam, direct final exam, that too also full suspense. And that's why it becomes kind of a lottery.
So you should
give marks not to the performance, but to the improvement quotient. How much you are ready to improve? We came to you last year and you were around A. You want to go in for final grading as A plus, then you require this delta, this change, this delta increase. That incremental change, can you do it in 1 year? Marks should be given for that. That is the improvement question.
Process. What is cluster doing currently? Not to the purpose. Working up with, interrupted you. Cluster is currently working up with creation of portals between the colleges and the cluster. with the current framework of AQAR, that within a month's time also we should be starting with it. Show your AQAR and you'll be able to tell you the lacune. Are you in a position to cover up, and what are the possible areas by which in that very year you can cover them up? By a continuous rapport with them and with a continuous updation with the colleges. So we are a little ambitious, and we expect some changes, maybe with the current, though there are too many lacunae with NAC. Let us start with NAC, this is what our thought is. And it is not NAC, it is the quality parameters that we are focusing on. So we are working on a variety of aspects. One happens to be with specific groups like the one that you are interacting with today, which will be dealing with the greater thought process that comes in. At a lower level where everybody needs to participate, how should the process of documentation be? What we found out was that the first document that is made itself is faulty. Now you make an e-copy of it and you put it on the cloud, it makes no sense. Unless the very first document is correct. Every time NAC comes out with queries, and they are so foolish that a report is submitted and it says that you have made a mention there are 80 students in that particular activity, whereas your list shows 67. And then you say, oh, no, it is 67 only, you know, and then that is to be settled out. So how to verify out, how to number the documents, how to make the process of documentation accountable, how to see to it that documentation is everybody's responsibility, which comes at the ground level, which comes at every level. And therefore, we're trying to work with some kind of courses whereby each one understands the basics. Our problems are with basics. Advanced is a different issue altogether. We are not able to function on our raw basics. And that is the reason why we are facing so many problems with accreditations. And we fear accreditation, as you were saying. So the objective is to remove the fear. We have a Telegram group which has more than 2,500 people pan-India. And any question that comes on that is actually answered out. Anyway, that process, that discussion would go on, it would not end up. Let's go ahead with the program. We'll definitely love to talk to you in the future.
Thank you. My pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Chitnis, because what you said about all these aspects about having different kinds of accreditation for different tiers, colleges, and also about what you said just now of the criteria for improvement, which is really something very insightful. And I'm sure all the participants today who have listened to you are going to end this session today and keep thinking about what you have talked about and how these things can be really changed in their institution. So I now request our mentors, Dr. Badrunisa and Dr. Mr. Piyush Pahale, to please talk about the 4-day seminar that has been organized by them and what were their views about the participation by the teams. So, Pahade sir.
Thank you so much. We started this course on the 3rd of August. This course is related to quality and not to NAC. But there has to be some guideline, and therefore we have kept NAC as a guideline. The quality aim, the course aims at making the participants think at a deeper level. It aims at thinking of those processes which we are actually working, but are we thinking about them? It goes on with very simple processes like an academic calendar and whether how it works, at what levels, what are the different levels of an academic calendar? What are the different types of academic calendar? Something very surprising if you try to find, go into the research and try to find out on academic calendar, you won't find anything. something that all of us are practicing is nothing is available. How it differs from a school and how it differs, how it is inside of organizations and colleges. We did not teach NAC to any of these participants. We gave them these aspects so that they rigorously go through that NAC manual and every question has been read by each one. Because how it applies to them is what was to be thought out. And we really feel that there is nothing called as a policy that goes on inside the organizations. I don't find colleges having policies. I don't find colleges having policies being implemented. Policies are made because NAC wants it. Or for that matter, policies are made because somebody feels policies should be made. They are not implemented. The worst part is that some organizations make policies, but they are not audited. What is the use of an unaudited policy? The basic of quality lies in checking what you do. Just as what you decide at the same time, what you do, whether what you do is right or wrong. And therefore, this entire course aims at making think deeper. It is for this reason, don't look at NAC in this way. Let us try to look at NAC in this way. Actually design a policy, let us see. In the second half now of this course, they are going to discuss, rather they will, it won't be surprising if they start arguing over each other on what the policy should be and how correct or how incorrect it is and what areas what are those areas which actually should have come into it? And the bigger part would be how it works in Kerala and how it works in Mumbai and how it works in Delhi and how it works somewhere in Punjab is when it will be worked out. A greater picture will be available because we have participants from these various states over here who are with full vigor, there is no doubt about it. So the objective of this course is so, and therefore their performances were very nice because I was closely watching them, their WhatsApp discussions, asking for the for time to conduct the meeting, they meeting each other online. There must have been at least 70 to 80 times that these people must have met each other or more than that, different groups together, I mean to say, to come to some conclusion and then present it out. And this is primarily because my thought happens to be that we don't share, educational community does not share. All communities share. A medical community shares after 9:30, after their clinic is over, they go, they sit, they may have drinks, that's a different issue. But they have some sessions, they discuss out on a particular issue related to medicals. Educational community, two teachers will talk everything except what they do inside the classroom. They never talk. And therefore, they never get ideas from each other. Education, teaching and learning is a very, 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 very private business between the student and the teacher, not to be shared with other teachers. And that is the core reason why we are not able to develop. That is the core reason why our students don't sit inside the classrooms. Some time ago, Raviji was making a mention saying that attendance plays a role. Attendance plays a role because we don't share. We don't tell how best I teach. We envy a teacher who is very popular. And we also envy a teacher into whose classroom nobody sits. So to change these processes, we need to share. And therefore, IPC Cluster India has its logo called as not competition, but cooperation. Let us cooperate on all these issues. With this view only, so that people share, so that they talk, they understand the other part of the world, they understand the other side of India, they interact with, and therefore these groups were formed so. And I think so, to a certain extent, we have succeeded because they all started interacting. As the days came closer, I could find a very large number of meetings taking place, some personal messages coming out, sharing out. And now a good number of messages coming up, so we are very thankful to you because we got a very good team member and we could discuss out to a very great extent and all those things. Now, objective is to share, to go for a collective knowledge, learning. It would be, we are knowledge workers. So let us work as knowledge workers rather than individually having big peaks and not sharing with the world because the peak is broken off from the community. This was the greater thought. We have tried to achieve it in the shortest possible time. And the results are in front of you. And for them, the story is not over because the harder part is to begin now. So with this brief say that I wanted to say, I hand it over back to you, Vaishnavi.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Badrunesa ma'am, would you like to give your views on the seminar and the presentations that have happened?
Thank you. Thank you for giving me time to talk to you. You all know that what this is. But today I would like to thank IQAC cluster and Kharat sir, the team of IQAC cluster, for bringing Dr. Ravi here. And really, really pleasure to be there today to listen him about the different types of accreditations. I learned a lot today. The kind of matrix to see that the core values and the different kinds of criterias what we are putting into. Piyush sir was telling, it will be my pleasure to talk to Ravi sir in person as my management also is planning to go for QS actually. And the responsibility is on my shoulder. And we are at the starting stage of this. So I'll be very much pleasure to talk to sir in person with the permission of Kharat sir and Piyush sir, Bhole sir, the panel members who all are here today. Apart from this, like about the course, the main objective of starting this course is to develop a quality. It is not for only NAC, as we all know, as Pahade sir also has mentioned this. And understanding and quality for the institutes, IQAC has taken a step as usual to help across Indian institutes, especially the rural institutes who really want and help to understand, to do the benchmarking, to improve their quality in the institute. As we believe that if the quality increases or quality is maintained throughout the institution, definitely any accreditation is not a big task. If you are working day by day on quality and you are documenting day by day the activities, what is happening in your institute, and you are having a continual check on improvements of your quality, your audits, everything, then aligning all that and putting into an criterias of any kind of an accreditation, maybe it is NAC, NBA, or any kind of an accreditation, is not a big task. We find very much difficulty when we start working on a NAC because we have not documented properly our activities. We have not taken care, though we are working on each and every point, but we have not documented, we have not seen the benchmarking, we have not seen the key indicators day to day, in day-to-day activities. Maybe it is teaching, maybe it is extracurricular activity, maybe it is mentoring. Generally, every teacher will mentor a student. every teacher in person, they will talk. If one student is sad, no teacher will leave that student simply like that. They'll ask, what is the reason? Why you are not coming to college? What exactly the thing? And they try to solve that. They try to convince that. We do this, but are we maintaining this? No, we are not doing that. That is the reason why we feel difficulty when we are uploading the accreditation applications. So this course is the one which is giving you a clarity that what exactly the meaning of quality, how to manage, how to understand, and how to maintain your documentation, and where and what kind of aspects to be given more weightage, and day to day how your you have to improve. This course is not only improving personal quality, but it also it is not only improving the institutional quality, but also it improves the personal quality. You will understand that how exactly this is going to help in managing your quality. With these few things, I would like to thank again for giving me a time to speak on this. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. And now I end the seminar with a vote of thanks. I profusely thank Pro Vice Chancellor of MIT.
Madam, Dr. Just 1 minute.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Karat, sir, to please.
Oh, yes. Sure, sir. Sure. Sir. Yeah, yeah. Yes, Dr. Karat. We would like you also to give your feedback.
Good evening to one and all. I'm very happy that all of you have taken a lot of efforts, and certainly you are doing really excellent work in the field of higher education. I am very much thankful to Professor Ravi Chitnis, who has happened to be a very good friend of me, and he has shared excellent, I mean, the insights on the higher education with reference to the accreditation. So thank you very much, sir, that you have spared your valuable time. And certainly our entire team of IQAC cluster who is always working for the quality benchmark. So congratulations to one and all. Thank you.
Pahade sir, with your permission, then shall
yes,
I
please.
yeah propose the vote of yes. Thanks. Yes. So thank you very much, Karat sir. I end now with a vote of thanks for all the people who were associated with this national seminar. First and foremost, I thank Pro Vice Chancellor of MIT, Dr. Ravi Chitnis, for his very, very insightful talk. I also would like to say that, you know, the concept of the national knowledge grid that he has put forth seems to be very, very interesting. I also thank the speaker for today, Principal Bharat Shinde, for acquainting all the participants about the Atal scheme that he has got his rank for. I profusely also thank the judges of this national seminar who have judged the sessions by all the teams who presented, Dr. Bhalchandra Pore, Dr. Vinita Pai, Dr. Machappa, Dr. Sony Alexander, and today Dr. Manjula Raja was there with us. So thank you very much to all the judges for giving their valuable comments on whatever we have presented. And I'm sure your comments will be taken up, and we will try to also look into the aspects which you have suggested to all of us. I thank the members of the IQAC cluster for organizing this kind of a seminar for the team members of the course. I thank Amit sir and his team of White Coat Technology for all their technical support. I also thank Dr. Nanwani, because she is the one who really worked hard to make those teasers which really send down a lot of excitement amongst all of us. And it was a very, very nice positive vibe that we all got when we saw those videos. So So thank you, Nanwani ma'am, for preparing those videos for all of us. And obviously, a big thank you to all my colleagues of the course, who the 21 participants that we have in the course, who have all who are from all the different parts of India, and who have come together to look at the aspects in as yesterday even Sony sir was saying, you know, not just what horizontally, but also diagonally through all the criteria, which was a very, very good kind of a insight that all of us have got, and the participants have in their particular topics have worked very hard to come up with the presentations. Obviously, all this has not happened without the guidance of our mentors. So a very, very big thank you to our mentors, Piyush Pahade sir and Badrunisa ma'am, because it was not without your guidance that we could have been able to do this kind of a presentation. You have not just given us an opportunity to present, but you have also given us an opportunity to look at all these things in a completely different perspective. And I think that is the major learning that we are all taking back with us after this seminar. And last but not the least, thank you to all the participants who have joined for this national seminar and have actively commented and have also given some of their views in the chat box, and who are also giving feedback. So today's seminar, today's talks also, please all of you give your feedback. Amit sir will share the link in the chat box for today's talks. So I request all of you to please give your feedbacks. All these feedbacks are extremely valuable to all of us, because we are all going to learn. We are all here to learn, and therefore we are going to learn through this seminar. So before we disperse, I request all of you to rise up for the national anthem, so that we will pay all respects to the country also. Amit, can we have the national anthem, please?
Sure.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब
सिंध गुजरात
उत्तर मराठा द्राविड उत्कल
Thank you to all of you, and a very good night to all of you.
Thank you all. Thank you. And congratulations to all the
participants.
This 4 days webinar, almost from 10 days, you all were rushing with the tension and the work and continuous sittings with Piyu sir, with me, and so many things has happened, but finally we have come to a very good end. It's really appreciable.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir.
Words are really encouraging. Thank you.
Thank you, Piyush sir. Thank you, Badrunisa madam.
Thank you, Bole sir,
for all the guidance.
Thank you.
Yes, today's team performed well. Huh?
Yes. Sir, may I request one small thing?
Yes, please.
All these 7 presentations we can put on LMS?
They will be on LMS. They will be shared to everyone. That goes without saying. It is your property. Today only I was talking to Amit. We also made a mention saying that would be a part of our repository now. So just as it will be shared, it will remain with us in the future also. Anytime you need to see it, you can see it. That is what we said. All the quality materials that are now coming up, they will remain with us. That is our intellectual that we have generated out. It is going to remain with us. It's not going to go forever.
Yes, sir.
We are creating a repository only, because it will be needed for reference now.
Someone
will need some reference. So we will be having this for reference. And it will remain with us. You can refer to it anytime. That's what the data is.
Participants
will be given. Yes, Professor. Only.
Can we have, Ravi Chitti's presentation on the LMS?
It will be available on the LMS. Second, all the videos are already available on YouTube. This is the second part. We'll be having the links also of it. That will also be there. So you can refer to it. You can see it. Definitely. Not any issue.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Definitely. After presentation will be awesome. They will be shared. Amit, kindly see to it that they get shared over there.
Amit, has written there that the feedback link is not opening. Somebody in the chat box has written that.
Let me share the link again.
Yeah.
I can access it maybe.
Hello, team.
Okay. Pendalka ma'am has said that it is opening. Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Yes, okay.
Okay, Sala. Sony, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Prashantula, madam. And Chikuri Gilette, Elizabeth.
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 In group photo, ho jaye.
Sure. कोई बात नहीं आपको एक काम दे देता हूँ ये आज दिया है ये ग्रेड बना लेते
हैं
नो प्रॉब्लम वी डोंट वांट अ हॉलीडे डोंट वरी
It's not only about a holiday, it is also giving an additional work. Uske bare mein keh raha hu. You will get the certificate. Somebody has posted how about a certificate. You will get the certificate. Bilkul. Certificate. There is something more to say. All the panelists who have presented ये सारे 21 पैनलिस्ट को नेशनल वेबिनार का प्रेजेंटेशन का सर्टिफिकेट मिला एज अ रिसोर्स
पर्सन
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ योर यस करिकुलम इट इज आल्सो इवेंट टू इवेंट का भी आपको मिल जाएगा और मैम गौनी जी क्या कहती हो आप
Sir, it was a wonderful experience, and after listening to Dr. Chitnis today, you have got the gem of people to guide us. And
keep on catching them for thing.
Yes, sir. And definitely, the way that we have read NAC manual this time is totally different, with a different perspective, with different lenses. So it's a wonderful experience. And I am happy to be a part of the course. So that's very nice. I am enjoying. Yes.
On interacting, we keep on sharing.
It is I used to feel generally just I want to share when I was studying, and when I have become a teacher, the way I read the same lesson to teach the student. I felt I would have read when I was a student.
Yes,
very rightly
and then
said. Yes,
I just would like to add here, madam, that is the reason one of my colleagues used to always say.
Ben was telling the same thing, that how we read the NAC manual now, how we were reading earlier. It is as same as like as a student, what I read that chapter in MSc or in my MPhil. When I started teaching the same chapter to the student, the way I read, I was feeling if this I would have read, I would have been
like that.
This is the difference between teaching and learning.
The teaching is double learning.
Mm.
Only teaching is
teaching is double learning.
Teaching is teaching. Learning is a different experience altogether. So
we are enjoying both the modes.
Yeah.
We are even enjoying teaching and we are enjoying learning the course. So we are enjoying both our roles.
If you enjoy learning, then life becomes very, very fantastic. Learning, it is not to be taken as in I will fail, what will happen to me. Agar aisa sochenge to it is very bad. When you are learning, if you take it, ki kyun nahi samajhta, isko samajhna chahiye, marks ke liye chhodo, samajhne ke liye samajhna. It makes a big, big difference. Then our egos go away and learning becomes very easy. Why I don't understand? No, it's a challenge for me. I want to learn. I want to know what it is. So automatically we open up all the other channels, and then learning really becomes very fantastic. तब तक वो तो रट्टा मार स्टाइल ही चलता है हमारा. We have been trained in that. Yes, but.
So may I say something?
We are waiting for you to say something. I have been watching you for quite some time. Why she is not speaking anything?
Sir, Pokna, I asked you for a holiday and you gave work. So I withdrew my speaking also. Okay, sir. What I want to say is this, that since we are 21, can we come up with some kind of written material, whether case studies related to policies or whatever, and then go in for a publication?
Coming up with policies first, this is one. First thing is we will first create those policies, frameworks of policies, so that all these institutions will be able to frame their own policies with this basic framework. This is one thing in my mind. And the second thing is, with the help of analytics, some analytics, like we have Deep over here, Deep is a mathematician. So, can we have, we already have our format of academic audit. Can we get some of the analytics in to see to it that, or we can even take help of Amit and Amit's company. They have some good mathematicians over there. So that our academic audits can be completed in time and they can also be very specific. Currently, our academic audits are horrible. All over India, I have seen at least 25 different types of audits conducted by different universities, colleges. They are in no way sensible. Kahi jagah pe to unko na sequence hai na kuch hai jo aa gaya humne wo dal diya hai. So can we create an audit? This is one thing. Tomorrow, ye audit hum cluster ke liye okay karwa lenge. Cluster ki taraf se, whenever colleges ask for an audit, we will give this audit. Where we can sit here and analyze it. Ki chalo aaj ek meeting lene wale hai, college ka audit karna hai. So chalo, baithte is college ko baith ke audit karte hai. Unke aaye hue sare parameters ko dekhte hai aur usko analysis karna shuru karte hai. Maybe if there is a physical visit, somebody will go and see it. Wherever it is, then we can send our report. This is the report that comes up. Physical visit mein jo dikhega, usko add ho jayega, phir baaki ka baaki. But that would be a very big learning experience for all of us. It is like all of us auditing. Over a period of time, it will help us to be better. We should be able to sense out what is good and what are the problems over there. So, We need to do this. We want this to be done.
Shall I add a little more for this, sir?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Actually, morning I was discussing with you that we can do something of writing on the same thing madam has started. Actually, we initiated this talk today, me and Piyush sir. We are going to come up with some kind of an assignment where either two members as one chapter or three members as one chapter like that. Then that is going to be a clear published where you will be a part of chapter writers. for that with an ISBN number and all, and we will copyright as per IQA.
अगर वैसा करते हैं तो cluster can go for ISBN number वगैरह, उसको उसे हम देख लेंगे.
What I'm saying, sir, publication has to be there with an ISBN number.
Yes. I was so with ISBN number and a copyright under IQAC cluster.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Once, madam, once ISBN is there, automatically the CC rights will come about, you know, so that we can do it. But I was thinking that after doing so much, all this effort, if we don't come out with a publication, okay, which is curated, see, you people are there to curate it, okay, then this effort is not going to have that much of an impact.
That's what I'm telling
you.
Me and PU sir was talking morning about the same. But we have to come out with a
problem. What is the issue?
Okay. Come in front of you.
Nanwani madam, what I will suggest you is, currently the problem with cluster is that we have limited resources, we have limited people. If some of you can take this responsibility, उसका कुछ पैसे का खर्चा आएगा वो हम देख ले सकते, उसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ये तो एक बात है. For somebody will need to be a little more accountable. Now all this exercise that we have done, this can actually come into something very fantastic. Because this is absolutely genuine. इसमें किसी का कुछ अलग नहीं है, कहाँ से कुछ आया material नहीं है. Everything is genuine, excellently analyzed. So actually, if we can go for it, it's great. So some of us will have to take a lead. I can help you out in all those areas, but कहीं पे तो भी उसका assessment होना चाहिए, reading होना चाहिए, उसका proof checking होना चाहिए. Content is not an issue, but it needs to be proof checked, read out, and all these things need to be done. How can we do it? Can we do it? That's great. If we can do it, it's better.
ना दो session लेने के बाद क्या हरू होता
है? Right now only, since we have 2 months left, okay. Yes. So you start with this assignment now. So all the 21 of us will contribute. At the end of 2 months, we will come up with something concrete. See, once the certificate course is over, of course there will be a commitment to the cause. But you never know, right? There can be a
diversion. What you say is right.
So right now only we should start. So that at the end of 2 months, we can produce this as evidence of success and impact.
Fantastic. This is a good idea. Okay, can anybody help me out in finalizing out some parameters for this?